Hello, everybody. I'm Steve Anton, and welcome to the Pheasant Run Resort Hotel in St. Charles, Illinois. This evening, the 1987 Classic Cup 6 9-Ball Tournament. If you love billiards, stay tuned, because we have a lot of action coming your way. This tournament began on Tuesday with an open division. However, we will be featuring the women's division, and we will be picking up the open division on a later telecast. Now, the women's division began on Friday with 32 players, and we are down to 2 finalists. Joining me on the telecast this year is a man who has worn many hats with regards to billiards. He is a tournament director, a professional pool player, and believe it or not, he was a consultant on the movie The Color of Money. I'd like to welcome Jay Helford. And Jay, we have a very competitive field, as I said, 32 players, and when you take a look at the 2 finalists, really no surprise with one of the young ladies.
Well, Jean Belukas is perhaps the greatest woman player of all time. She's 6 times world champion. She's won the last 9 tournaments in a row she's entered. So, yes, it's no surprise for her to be in the finals. And it's really no surprise for her opponent, Eva Mattia, to be here either.
Eva Mattia, the young Swede who now makes her home in Michigan. She is ranked 5th on the Women's Professional Tour. And what is Eva going to have to do to defeat Jean this evening?
She's going to have to keep Jean in her chair for a while. Yeah. Interestingly enough, the last person to defeat Jean was Eva in Charlotte, in a tournament in Charlotte last year, and she won decisively. She won a match 9-2. So it's been about 8 long months since Jean's lost a match, so we'll see what happens tonight.
We should mention the ladies will be playing for a purse of $20,000. The first place prize money is $6,000, so the young ladies really have something to shoot for. We're just about set for the start of tonight's action, but before we do so, we need the introduction of the players, and we have the tournament director for tonight, and that's Joe Kerr. And Joe, why don't you take a look at the players and introduce them, if you please.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Jay and Steve, for their fine introduction. On behalf of the Pool and Billiard Magazine, the Over Trading Company, who is the distributor of these fine Soren Sogard pool tables, and Renita Claw, and the Willard Q Schaefer Company, I'd like to welcome you all to the 6th Annual 9-Ball Classic Cup at the beautiful Pheasant Run Resort Hotel in St. Charles, Illinois. I would first like to commend both of our contestants. We're coming through a star-studded field of over 32 women this week. They certainly played well, and I think they deserve a round of applause for that. At this time, I'd like to introduce our first player. She's from Grand Ledge, Michigan. She's 23 years old. She was the 1981 Swedish Open champion, the 1981 European Open champion. She won the 1983 and 84 Clyde Childress Championship. She was the 84, 85, and 86 Midwest Open champion. She was runner-up in the 1984 and 85 U.S. Open Championships. She's sponsored by Willard's Q-Tip Shapers and Scuffers. How about a nice hand for Miss Eva Mattia? Player is from Brooklyn, New York. She's 27 years old. She is 7 times U.S. Open champion, 6 times world champion. She also won the 1986 $10,000 first prize at the Resorts Hotel in Atlantic City. She's the 1986 WPBA PBA champion. She also has a high run of 134 balls. She's won over 50 major tournaments. She's sponsored by Black Billiards of New York. Got a nice hand for the queen, Miss Jean Belukas. Hey, ladies. Good luck. Hey, you guys can just warm up. You want to start on set.
When you graduate from college, what will you be able to offer an employer?
I like working with people.
I really like working with people.
I really like people.
I'm a people person.
I'm eager.
Eager. I think I'm eager.
And I was president of
FI. Offer an employer something meaningful, practical work experience. A nationwide college program called Co-op Education can give you that competitive edge.
And I'd even relocate.
Write Co-op Education. It's the experience you need for the job you want.
All right, welcome back. We're at the Pheasant Run Resort Hotel in St. Charles, and we're just about to get underway with tonight's action. We should mention that the prize money for the ladies is not $6,000, like I said. I believe it's around $3,500.
It's $3,200 for the winner, $2,300 for second place.
Wishful thinking on my part. I'm sure the ladies would love to have $6,000, right?
Well, you got confused because the men's prize fund was $6,000 first prize.
And as we said on the pregame, we will be featuring that open divisions or men's tournament, if you call it, a bit later on. Let's take a look at the results for the ladies and see how they got here. And there you see the third through eighth place finishers, Jay.
Right. Eva Mattia just defeated Lori John Jones to get into the final match. What you're watching right now, Steve, is a leg for the break. The player whose ball gets closest to the rail wins a leg. It's very close. Jean Belukas wins a leg. She'll break first. Now, Steve, you may know that Jean is undefeated at this time. Eva has lost one match. So she has to defeat Jean Belukas two sets, race to nine each set, to win this championship. Whereas if Jean wins the first set, the first race to nine, she'll be the champion. So Eva's the decided underdog here.
Jean Belukas, a six-time U.S. Open champion. A knee injury last year curtailed her play, but she has come back strong to win nine tournaments in a row, and she breaks. And she may get that nine ball. And right off the bat, Jean Belukas breaks on top 1-0 as she broke, and the nine ball just gently fell in that corner pocket, Jay.
That's what they want to do. You won't see that too often.
And just take a look at it again.
Oh, there we go. There's a replay.
You see the nine ball?
One of the balls kicked over, hit the nine, knocked in the corner pocket. If the nine ball goes in the break, it will usually go in one of the corner pockets.
And a look at Eva Mattia there. She's got to be wondering to herself, hey, I'm up against the odds to begin with, and then all of a sudden Jean Belukas breaks.
If Jean gets rolling, this could be over before we know it.
Belukas?
Excuse me. She's a very powerful player, an explosive player. There goes the nine again. Oh! Nine kicked the cue ball in.
The nine?
We'll have ball in hand behind the head string. The head string's marked by the second diamond. Any balls that went on the break will be spotted up.
That nine ball was headed for that corner pocket again.
Again. She's got a very powerful break shot.
So the Swede, Eva Mattia, now making her home in Michigan, will step up. She is a former European champion. And as Jay said earlier, she was the last player to defeat Jean Belukas.
She defeated her at Charlotte, North Carolina last fall. It's a spot shot on the one ball. The one's on the spot. Cue ball behind the line. Good shot. She wants to bring that cue ball down the table far enough to shoot the two in the side. She didn't quite get as far as she would like.
We should mention for the neophytes out there that in nine ball, you must hit the balls in numerical order. For example, if you break and hit the one ball in, you must follow it to two, three, four, and five on up through nine.
That's correct. It's a tough shot here. She's got to cut that two ball backwards a little bit. That's it. Nice shot. The way the balls are sitting, Steve, I suspect that Eva's going to try and play a billiard off the three into the nine and make the nine ball.
Looking for that combination. Do you get a good look at Eva?
She can actually attempt to make the three ball in the upper left corner pocket and at the same time play a billiard on the nine. Was wrong. She played a safety. She tried to tie Jean up and put the three ball behind the six, but it didn't get there.
I think she gave some thought, though, to that combination, then looked it over and decided, well, as you said, I'll play it play it on the safe side.
Looks like Gene's banking the three. Cross side. Yep. Oh. The nine on a billiard. Nice shot.
Beautiful shot. She had the combination. She kicked the four and the cue ball off the four, dropped the nine ball in, and Belukas takes a 2-0 lead. And you can't let the champion get on top, because when she gets that big lead, she can run the table very quickly.
Here's the break shot, game three. She made a ball on the break. Well, she broke them out pretty good, but she's got a real tough shot on the one ball here. Looks like she's playing a safety here on the one. No, she shot it in. She made a good shot, but she scratched cross side. Eva's gonna have ball in hand anywhere on the table. The one's respotted. Eva can place the ball anywhere she'd like now.
So a break now for Mataya. As he tries to break onto the scoreboard, she's down 2-0.
The 3-6 is a little bit tied up. That's what she's considering. Can she run these balls?
They like to know we feel that strand light is still on.
Like she's playing a combination here. Yep. Good shot. Good shot. Great shot, Steve.
She thought about it for a long time, and then she decided to go for that combination, and it paid dividends.
She actually played a combination billiard. Very unusual shot. Here's the replay on it. One into the nine, off the two, and into the corner pocket. Quite a shot there. Gets her right back in the match. She's down 1-2.
Well, definitely a confidence booster for Mataya.
Oh! Ooh.
At nine
she made
ball.
A ball. She's got a good shot at the one in the side pocket. The balls are spread out real well. She may be able to run these balls. Eva's one of the few women who's not intimidated by Gene. Gene has been playing in national championships since she was 11 years old. She's 27 and she's a 17-year veteran.
Hard to believe, only 27 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's got to be a great confidence booster, as we said. Mataya has defeated Belukas, and she's not threatened by her, the mystique, so to speak, that Belukas may present when she steps out onto the table. And Mataya now looks like she has all the confidence in the world as she's attempting to run this table.
She's playing real well right now. That was an excellent shot to kick that nine out and give her a shot at the three. She's got to play this well to beat Gene. Another good shot. She'll shoot the four in the side now. brings the cue ball out to the middle of the table for the six. Very good, very good.
That cue ball, she's placing that cue ball just in the right spot, and it's setting her up for those easy shots.
Her position play is excellent. That shot, she didn't quite hit it as hard as she would like. She'd like to be a little bit further across the table. This is a relatively tough shot here on the eight ball. Hit it very well, hit it very well. Nice run out here.
Mataya in position to tie this match at two, and she does.
Great. Call it instinct, Steve, but I'm picking Eva Mataya to win this first set.
Well, since I'm sort of a novice at this, I'm going to stick with the.
You're going to play it safe.
The favorite, yes, I'll
okay.
play it safe.
Okay.
So we are knotted up at two, and we should mention that this is a race to nine. If Mataya should happen to get there 2-9, we will have a second game which will decide the championship. If Belukis wins this particular match, she is the champion.
Another ball on the break. She's maybe tied up behind the seven and she can't see the one ball. Now, after the break shot, the incoming player, in this case Eva Mataya, because she made a ball on the break, has the option to push out, which means she can roll the cue ball anywhere on the table she'd like. If she does that, Jean will have the option to take the shot or give it back to Eva, although the way she's looking at this, I think she's gonna shoot this combination on the 1-9. She can see the one ball. She's shooting at the nine ball here, the 1-9 combo. Nope.
Well, you gotta give her credit, she went for it. Decided not to play it safe and decided to go for the gold, so to speak.
Yeah. Now, Jean's doesn't have a clear shot. The six is between the one and the corner pocket. She's probably shooting a combination here, the 1-6. She did. She returned the favor. She left Eva tied up here. Eva's tied up behind the seven ball. She's going to have to go rail first and kick at the one. If she's not successful in hitting the one, she'll give Jean ball in hand. Had a nice kick there. Again, Jean does not have a clear shot at the pocket. She may opt to try a billiard off the one ball into the five, or a combination one into the five.
Either way you look at it, not really much in the way of a clear shot for Jean.
Right. Looks like she's shooting the combination, the one into the five. No, excuse me, it was a billiard. She hit the one first, sent the cue ball into the five and made it. Yeah, she's got a good shot. The one in the upper left-hand corner, the three is right next to it, which will be the next ball. Ooh. Sounded a little bit like a miscue there.
Ball kicked in and out.
That's something that you see very rarely from the cue of Jean Belukis, a miss at an open ball. Could be an opportunity for Eva to take the lead. Gina's working on her Q-tip on the side of the table there. Uh-oh. Well, Eva missed a relatively easy shot.
So, Eva returns the favor, so to speak, to Gene, and Belucas now had a chance to run the table and take the lead.
It's kind of a tight fit getting past the seven ball to make the three, but she can make it. She went rail first. Let's see what happens here. She can't see the four. She's behind the eight ball. She's going to have to kick. They're struggling this game. Eva's got an open shot at the four. She can make this four and get her cue ball down on the six. I think she'll get this rack.
You see the four ball just lying off the seven, and that gives Mataya a clear shot.
She's using upper right-hand English here to bring the cue ball down for the six on the left-hand side of her screen. Uh-oh. She got the cue ball over, but she touched the seven and left it in her way. This seems like the rack for these girls to get hooked. She's got a kick at the six. These kick shots are difficult. It's difficult even to hit the ball, let alone make it. Ooh, almost kicked it in.
Looked good from this vantage point, but at the last moment, kicked in and out.
She got a good roll there. She didn't give Gene anything. We've seen more kick shots this game than we'll probably see the whole rest of the match.
I'm sure both players still, despite their long involvement with the game, still have some butterflies floating around.
Always in the championship match. Gene made a good kick. Left Eva a straight in shot. She's got the six straight in the end, the lower left corner. In nicely.
Looks like she's in pretty good position, Jay.
She'll shoot the seven in the upper left corner, draw the cue ball back to make the eight in the side.
Nice drawback.
Again, she'll shoot the eight in the side, draw the cue ball out to the middle of the table. And now she's got a nice shot on the nine ball.
Mataya with a nice run has taken the lead 3-2.
So both players more or less left the door open for one another, and it was just a matter of time as to who would answer it. And Mataya was the one to come up with the victory, and she takes the lead, as you see out there on your screen, 3-2.
This is shaping up like a good match here.
What's going through Belucas's mind right now? I mean, I can't imagine she's been down in too many matches throughout the course of the year.
She's quite a competitor. Actually, in reaching the finals, Gene won five matches in a row. The closest match was 9-5. That was with Eva Mataya earlier today. So she hasn't really been tested in this tournament. But she's quite a competitor. She keeps her composure no matter what. Eva made a nice break here. She's got the ball spread out real well. Shoot the three in the side, stop the cue ball right there. The four ball's right on the side rail. I think she's going to get this rack.
The balls are positioned very well. As you said, Jay, they're scattered throughout the table. And so far, she's in a good position with that cue ball.
Shoot the four ball straight down the rail. And the five ball's right in front of the corner pocket. Yep. There it is. She's right there. She goes two rails for position. She's straight in on the six. The players try to keep an angle. She hit that ball good. She had to force that cue ball out of the corner. Eva's a real determined competitor right now. She knows what she's up against. She knows she's playing the best. She's got to play the game of her life to win.
Well, certainly right now she has all the confidence on her side, and she has that third element in any sport, and that's momentum.
That's right. She's rolling. She's on a roll. I've seen Jean in a lot of tournaments, and she's never out of a match. She can be down several games and come right back. Jean's capable of winning three or four games in a row. Okay. She's got to cut that nine ball in the upper left-hand corner pocket. Eva's right down with her chin on that cue stick. She plays the European style, which is down low. Good shot. Good shot.
So Mattia, there, you get a good look at the young Swede, has taken a 4-2 lead. And she ran at table that time with without much difficulty, Jay.
Well, she got the ball spread out, and she did the job. She did what she needed to do. Interesting enough, Eva's maiden name is Swenson. She came over here to play in the World Championship in 1981 and met Jim Mattia, who's one of the men's champions. He never let her go back to Sweden.
Love at first sight, right?
Yeah. Now they have a one-year-old child, a beautiful girl named Nicole, who's here at the tournament tonight with her father. He's babysitting. He got knocked out of the tournament earlier, the men's tournament. Another good break shot. Nothing went in, though. Nothing went in. Okay.
So
Jean's
now,
Jean's gonna shoot the one ball down the rail, try to bring the cue ball across the table to play the billiard from the two to the nine. I don't know if we can pick that up, but the two and the nine are very close together on the right-hand side of the table. And she'd like to make the one and come down there and play the billiard off the two into the nine. The trick is, how do you get your cue ball down there? That's what she's trying to figure out right now. Okay, she's going to shoot the one on the end. There it goes. She got it. She got it. So now, if we can see that 2-9, yes, that's what she's looking at right now. She's going to have to draw the cue ball off the two into the nine. A difficult shot, but it can be made. And Jean Beloukas is the person who can make it. Perhaps not. She may be playing it safety here. I don't see. Yep, she's playing it safety. Nope, she didn't do it. She wanted to roll the cue ball behind the nine, and it didn't work. She hit the nine going in. Eva Mattia is looking at that two ball to see if it will pass the three and go into the lower right corner pocket.
From our vantage point, it doesn't, looks like the 3 and the 2 ball pretty much on the same line. Let's see what she, how she plays it.
I think the 2 will go by. Yes, it will. She made it. Good shot.
You know something? I've got glasses on, and you don't. You saw that better than I did.
Right up for the 4 ball. That's the 4 on the right hand side of our picture. She'll shoot the 4 and try to roll the cue ball back and forth on the table to get position on the 5. Looks like a good shot. Very nice shot, very nice shot. Now she's got this rack set up too. That's the whole object, to get in position for the next ball. Once they do that, if they can stay in line, stay on position, they'll run the balls. Except for that momentary lapse in the 3rd game, he was played terrific.
Played very consistently. She ran the table on our last game, and now she's looking to do the same here.
And I like her chances. She shoots a 7 ball in the upper right-hand corner pocket. Nice shot she made there. She had to get it past the 9. She's got this rack, Steve. That's it. That was the last tough shot. She'll just make the 8 in the side and stop the cue ball right there. Just draw it back a hair. Just like that. 9 straight in.
And Mataya will take a 5-2 lead. And the big shot right there was when she hit the 4 ball in and left herself with a nice position to hit the 5, and then it was just a matter of time before she ran him, Jay.
Exactly, exactly. He was pulling out to a nice lead here. A 3-game lead is a big lead. It's only a race to 9.
We should mention once again, if Mataya does in fact get to 9 and win this match, we will go to a tiebreaker, so to speak, because
right.
Balukas and Mataya will have 1 loss apiece.
That's correct. Nothing went on the break. The 2 didn't quite get there. All right, these balls are spread out for Jean Balukas. If she's going to do something this match, she better do it right now. I don't see any real problems for her here. Of course, something could come up. The 2 in the lower left-hand corner. Shoot the 3 in the upper right-hand corner. Can just stop right there for the 4 ball, maybe bring it back just a hair. Yep, she did. Now she wants to shoot the 4 in the side, roll the cue ball back across the table for the 5 ball. Cue ball should come right this way. There you go. Looks like she's shooting the 5 all the way down on the end. Nope, side pocket, my mistake. Now she's got the six right in front of the corner pocket. She rolls back up for the seven ball in the same corner pocket. Eight ball will also go in the same corner pocket. She follows the cue ball. Back down the table, she's got a nice shot on the nine. There you go.
This certainly was a very quick run, and Belukas didn't waste any time in taking the advantage away from Mattia. Mattia, of course, broke, and nothing fell in, and Belukas subsequently ran it.
That was the real Jean Belukas there. She can do that rack after rack after rack, if given the opportunity. Of course, the object in this game is to make a ball on the break and keep running those racks. If you put those racks together and keep your opponent in the chair, there's no defense. Nothing on the break. Even Mattia comes back to the table. She's taking a look at the two ball to see what she has to do to get on that after she makes the one. That's the two right down there in front of Eva. She's got a long, tough shot on the one ball, though, first. That's the one right next to the nine on the right-hand side of the picture. Very nice shot. She's going to be right on the two. She'll make the two, draw back for the three. Like that, like that. She wants to hit that five hard. This makes it a little tougher. She's got a cue over the top of the five ball. This is a hard shot anyway. This is a thin cut on the three. She's got a little bit of a problem here. Well, she's queuing next to the five. I think she'll make this. She does. Position means everything. Nope, she hit the seven ball, left herself on the end rail. She's in a tough spot here. She's not wasting any time. She's going for it. She's gonna try and shoot that four ball all the way down in the end on the far left-hand side of the screen. Great shot. Great shot. Boy, Eva's playing well.
You hear the crowd up here. Yeah, great shot as the four ball just hugged the rail and kicked in that corner.
You can tell when a player is playing with confidence, they don't waste any time.
Well, certainly Mattia not wasting any time on this particular sequence.
Good shot. Good shot.
And now the balls are spread out to Mattia's liking.
She makes this little six ball shot and comes across table for the seven. She's got this rack. She did it. She did it. She's fine. She's fine. Slides off the nine ball. Eva's not letting up. She senses the victory. Follows that cue ball two rails out of the corner. No problem here, Steve. She's looking at it. She's just using some care.
Now she sets herself up beautifully for the nine ball.
That's what they call a hanger. When it's close and you're straight in on the nine ball, that's a hanger. Great.
So Mattia, after the break by Belukas, had a couple of tough shots. She weathered the storm, so to speak, and then the table opened up a little bit for her, and she ran it.
She sure did. She's playing real well, Steve.
And as you can see on your screen, Mattia now leads at 6-3. And once again, we should mention this is a race to nine.
Here's Jean Belukas. She doesn't look any too thrilled about the situation. She'd like to win this first set and get it over with. Even made a ball on the break.
So
she's tied up. She's tied up. The six and the three are both in her, in between the cue ball and the one ball. She will roll out here. She'll roll her cue ball somewhere on the table. And after she rolls out, that's my prediction. I'm pretty sure she won't try to shoot this. After she rolls out, Jean will then look at it and make a decision whether or not she wants to take the shot or give it to Eva. Eva's shooting over here in the corner. Uh-oh. She didn't want that eight ball to come back and kick the cue ball. The eight ball came back, kicked the cue ball out, and Jean has an open shot at the one. That was kind of a careless error there. She didn't want to give Jean an easy shot like this. One ball straight in the corner there. Comes right over for the two. Her cue ball may have gone a little further than she wanted. She'd like to have a little bit less of an angle.
The two ball is hung in the rail.
Yeah, she'll make the two. The difficult part of this shot is getting in good position for the three by the side pocket. Well, this is no bargain here. She's kind of like in no man's land. Three doesn't quite go in the side and doesn't quite go in the end. This is tricky. She's shooting it in the end pocket, it looks like. Ooh. Just slid in there.
Somebody opened up one of the exit doors and that ball fell through. So now Beluca's on a bit of a run.
She needs this run. She's going to try and shoot the four in the lower right-hand corner. And does. The greatest woman player of all time. That's what everybody says about her. She loses about one or two matches a year. I think she's got a better record than Navratilova in tennis.
That's saying a lot.
Yeah. This is not where she wanted to be on the seven ball. And she overcut it and missed it. She got herself in bad position there.
So Mataya now with a chance to clear the table and take a commanding lead.
Yeah, Gina's definitely struggling here. She's played much better than this all through the week. She's made three or four errors here that I haven't seen her make in the last couple days. And Eve is just getting stronger and stronger. Eva will shoot the eight down on the end. Bring the cue ball back just, a few inches, and then she'll have the nine straight in the other corner. Yep, there it is.
Beautiful position with the cue ball. She sizes up the nine ball, and she will take a 7-3 lead.
Wow. I think Eva's going to win this first set.
So far, your instincts are proving correct.
I'd never count Jean out, though.
You saw a quick look at Beloukis and trying to mentally get herself back in the game. Physically, there's really nothing wrong with her, and it's just a mental letdown right now.
She's upset. Yeah, she's upset with herself for making that mistake on the seven ball there. She got out of line. She didn't get in position where she wanted to be. Nothing on the break. The nine's moving down towards the corner pocket. She didn't give Jean much of a shot on the one ball, though. Cue ball down there buried in the upper right-hand corner pocket. The one out towards the right-hand side of the table. She shot at it. Missed it. It was a tough shot. I think she's just trying to get loosened up. She's a little tight right now. Eva's got a tough shot on the one here, but if she can make this shot and get on the two, she may take this rack too. She's going to shoot that one in the lower right-hand corner. She made a real nice shot there on the one ball. Beautiful woman. She was once a candidate for Miss Sweden. Bet you didn't know that, Steve. She'll shoot the two in the corner here, and I think she has a combination 3-9 if she can make this two, which she should. She's all right.
For a moment, it looked like that cue ball was going to go into that corner pocket.
That side pocket, it was
that
close.
Side pocket.
Now, the 3-9 is real tricky here. She's lining up the combination. She wants to shoot the 3 into the 9 and get this game over with.
But it's a sharp, good look at it.
Yeah, it's a sharp cut shot here for the 3 into the 9. This is a tough shot, but she can make it.
It's going to come right into your living room if she gets it.
Ooh. Look at this. Well, she brought the cue ball all the way down to the end of the table. And Jean will have a tough time making this 3 ball. It's long green and a thin cut. Jean missed the hole ball. That can happen when you're trying to hit the ball that thin.
You know, Mattia has had her share of misses this evening. However, when she has missed, she has not given Jean a good position.
Exactly. That's kind of the luck of the roll sometime. As the players say, the pool gods have been shining on Eva. Shoot the 4 in the lower left corner. She's trying to come around the 5 ball. Nope, didn't quite get there. She wanted to go around the 5 ball and play the 5-9 combination. Now she's going to have to run out. And the tough part's going to be that 6 ball, which is right by the side pocket. It's in a real difficult spot. There's the 5. She'll make that shot. But see the 6 just behind it there? Yeah, she's trying to figure out where she needs to get to make that 6 ball. She's even having thoughts about playing a billiard from the 5 into the 9. Nope. She's going to... Yep, she did. She tried to play a billiard from the 5 to the 9. She knows the 6 is tough, so it doesn't matter so much that she missed that shot, because now Jean has the predicament of how to run these balls. Good shot. She's going to have to run this 6 all the way down the rail to the left corner pocket. Nope. That's a real tough shot to keep on the rail.
Nice camera work that time is the green, the six ball tried to hug that corner pocket and it didn't materialize, and now Mattia with a chance to run the table.
She's in perfect shape for the 7 ball. Softly, 7 in the corner, rolls up. She'll shoot the 8 in the lower right corner here. And roll the cue ball down the table for the 9.
Just looking to go in that corner pocket.
Yep.
She would like to have gone a little farther with the cue ball here. She left herself a difficult shot. She just didn't stroke the ball. She needs to make this shot. Keep the pressure on. She knows it. She's going to cut this ball in the corner pocket. Just like that. Oh, it hung up. It hung up. This is Jean's opportunity here. It's a long shot, but Jean will make this ball. That might be the break Jean needs.
So, that's a two-game swing as far as the lead is concerned. If Mattia would have shot that one in, it's an 8-3 lead. However, Mattia now with that miss gives Belukas a chance to get back in this game, and now it's a 7-4 contest, and that may be the break Belukas was looking for.
That's right. She's back in the match. If Mattia would have made that 9-ball, I'd say this first set was over. Let's see what Jean can muster up here. She needs a rally. Looks like the cue ball's going to scratch. Sure did. It's tough on a player to run all those balls, get down to the 9, miss the 9. Now she has to come back to the table and start all over again with the 1. 9-ball's a tough game that way. The closer you get to winning, you're also getting that much closer to losing. You can run the first 8 balls, and if you miss the 9, you haven't done a thing. I don't think that's shaken Eva's confidence. She knows what she has to do. The balls are spread nice. She'll make that 2 in the end. Draw back for the 3 in the side, just like that. Well, no, she's going to shoot the 3 in the other end. She'll shoot the 3 to our right. Down at that end pocket there. In the upper right-hand corner. Rolls it in slowly. 5 in the side. She's working her way through this rack nicely so far. This is a tough shot to get, not to make the ball, but to get to the 6. She got her cue ball back across the table very well. It's a knowledgeable crowd. They understand that and they respond. She'll draw back for the 7 after she makes the 6. Very good.
Nice position on that drawback.
Yes. Stroke here, drew the ball off the side rail. A little bit of a tough shot on the 8 here. Just gonna shoot the 8. The left-hand corner, now our right. She's a good shot maker though. Got it, she's in good shape, slides right over for the 9. Looks good, looks good.
So, Mattia will take an 8-4 lead. We're at the Pheasant Run Resort Hotel in St. Charles. More 9-ball competition coming up in just a moment. We're back to action as Mattia now with an 8-4 lead, and she has one more game. in order to force a tiebreaker, but Lucas, and I get the feeling that Gene may just want to get this game over with and wipe the slate clean and go on to a new set.
Maybe, but I don't think she's going to quit on it. She can come back and win this set. Yeah, she can come back and win this set, but yeah, it's kind of looking like she's prepared for a second set. Eva's on the hill. That's our term for when a player needs one game to win a set. If Eva can win this ninth game, we'll come right back with a second set. There's really not much Gene can do with this one ball. She banked it. Great shot. That was a terrific shot. She's close to the two ball, but nowhere to go. I think she'll play a safety here. Yep, she's going to come off the two ball and try to hide Eva behind the three and nine. She did it. She did it. Forcing Eva to kick at the two ball.
I can imagine that's one of the more difficult shots in billiards to kick.
To kick accurately. Thought she could see the edge of the two and she didn't. So Jean's got ball in hand.
Ball in hand for Belukas, and she has a chance now to run the table. The balls appear to be fairly well spread out.
Yeah, maybe. No particular problems here, Steve. Of course, Jean's had a couple racks like this where she didn't get out. This is a position we rarely see Jean Belukas in, trailing in a match. First time this week she's been behind. She's led every match from start to finish. But you're going to see a real champion here. This cue ball is going down the table too far. She didn't want to get that close to the pocket. Nope, she missed it. I don't think Eva can see the whole four ball. I think she's partially hooked behind the eight. We'll see when she, yeah, she's down on it. Play to safety. Shoot the four off the rail. Bring the cue back down table. She wanted to leave the four on the end rail in the middle of the rail, and she did not do that. She left Gina's shot here. She makes the four. Uh-oh. She got hooked behind the nine. She got no shot at the five. This is looking more and more like Eva's set.
You see the cue ball hooked behind the nine ball, and Gene plays it safe.
Yeah. Eva's got a shot at the five. It's a long shot, but she can shoot at it. This is an opportunity for her to win this first set right now. She can make this five and get her cue ball in good position for the six. This first set's history. Bit of a tough cut shot on the six. Nice shot, nice shot. Eva wants this match bad. She wants to be the person to dethrone Gene Belukas. I think the girls are getting tired of Gene winning every tournament. Like I said, since she came back for a knee injury, she's won nine tournaments in a row. stretching back a period of about 8 months now. She's won every major championship she's entered.
Is there any record for a consecutive tournament
championship? This is it. This is it right now. About 20 years ago, a lady named Dorothy Wise won 5 World Straight Pool Championships in a row. She went a little further than she wanted, but she still should be able to make this. She'd like to be straight in on the 9. She's going to have to cut it in the side. I don't think she'll have any problem, though. This 9 ball, yeah.
It's for the game.
And set. That's it. That's it.
So, Eva Mataya, with a couple of breaks, has taken this first game 9-4, and now each player has 1 loss apiece, and we will be taking a look at the championship round, as there you see Eva getting a hug from her husband, who's sitting in the VIP area. So Mataya captures the first game 9-4, as I said, each game. Each player now has 1 loss apiece.
Everybody stand up just a second.
Okay, so we're going to take a 7th inning stretch, so to speak, as tournament director Joe Kerr put it so nicely. And we'll be back with more action, the championship round for the ladies tournament coming up, Mataya versus Belukis, right after this. The 9 ball championship, Classic Cup 6. Mataya winning the first match.
First set.
I'll get it straight yet. 9-4. And now this set will decide the champion. What you're seeing right now is the lag. And
lag for the one break. Another close one. Eva won that.
So Mataya now will attempt to dethrone the champion. Well, actually, we will have a new champion because the champion from a year ago was, of course, dethroned.
Belinda Bearden. She finished 5th this year.
So a new champion will be crowned. Belukis was really not tested in the throughout the tournament, and consequently she has an undefeated record, and now, well, she had an undefeated record until Mataya handed her first loss, and now we are...
That's the first set tied. She's lost in 8 months.
First set, that is unbelievable.
Yep. She's probably, Jean's probably won about 50 matches in a row until now. You're going to see a determined Jean Belukis this set. She doesn't like to finish 2nd in tournaments. Jean comes to win. He was starting right off where she left off last match. Broke the balls good, made a ball. She's got them spread out. To me, from this position, she's going to try and play the 3-9 combination. I'm surprised she went this way. This is not an easy shot here.
Well, she's certainly sizing that up, Jane. It looks like she's going to go for broke, so to speak.
She's going for it. It's a tough shot. Ooh. Well, the 9 came back and hooked Jean again. Jean's also taken up where she left off, behind the 9 ball.
We're going to take a look at that once again, Jay. Let's take a look at the combination attempt.
Yeah, she had to hit it a little bit thinner to make that 9. It was a tough shot. I was kind of surprised she went that way. Jean's kicking off the side rail there into the 3. She missed the ball. Thank you.
So Mattia now, with ball in hand, he has a chance to do some damage and jump in front in his third and final set.
Got an upset in the making here.
Mattia won the first set 9-4, and that consequently handed Balukas her first loss, and thus has forced the second game, and this is for the championship.
He's got to shoot the five in the corner, bring the cue ball back and forth across the table. Tough shot. Let's see. This is a difficult position she's in here. She's going to bank the seven ball. I think what she's going to do is she's going to try and play safe. She's going to bank the seven ball around the table, three rails, and hold the cue ball behind the nine. Let's see. Nope, she tried to make the seven. She tried to bank the seven right in. She didn't do it. The seven bounced back across the table, and Jean's got a straight in shot. Look out. This ball might scratch. It does. Jean just can't seem to get anything going.
So a break for Mattia as Balukas scratched on that seven ball.
Eva will have ball in hand.
Ball in hand, correct.
She should get these three balls with no trouble. Shoot the seven in the corner, draw the cue ball up the table a little ways. Just like that. She's perfect on the eight. You want to keep a little angle, Steve. You don't want to get straight in. It's too hard to maneuver the cue ball if you're straight in, but as long as you've got an angle, you can roll that cue ball where you want it. The only ball you want to be straight in on is the nine, and she's straight down the end rail on the nine. There it is. That's a good view. Straight in. Right in.
So Mattia breaks on top, takes the first game 1-0 in this final set for the championship.
I don't think I've seen Jean so helpless in years.
This seems like she really can't get started.
She had a golden opportunity to win that first game, and she threw it away when she scratched. Jean played in the open division with 63 men. She was the only woman in the field, and she actually won several matches against top players and finished in the top 24, was in the money. She won $500 in the open division. She's the only woman out there that would even attempt something like that.
Well, it certainly tells even a novice follower of billiards that Jean certainly has credentials that run from here to eternity.
No one's got a record like her in the annals of women's pool.
Looking for the one ball right now, Balukas is.
Well, she's hooked, so she's going to roll out. What happens here, the five ball gets spotted back up. Eva will have the option to either take this shot at the one or give it to Jean.
Now, why don't you explain what the strategy was behind that last shot?
Well, the strategy there was for Jean to put the ball in such a position where Eva wouldn't shoot it and would give it back to her, and she could do something with it. And that's what she accomplished. It's a little bit too difficult for Eva, but Jean thinks she can do something with this ball. I don't know if she can make that shot now. She's playing safe. She wanted to hook Eva behind the five and the nine. She didn't do it. Although Eva doesn't have any kind of open shot here, she can play a safety. I suspect she'll bank the one down the table to our left and bring the cue ball behind the other balls. Let's see how this works. She did. Successfully. Now Jean's tied up behind the 5 and 9. I think she's got to go off the end rail. She did. She hit it. She made a good hit. She didn't leave Eva much. Eva will play some kind of safety here. What, I'm not sure. Bring the 5 across the table, and again, put the 5 and 9 in between the cue ball and the object ball.
So both players right now, very cautious in their shots.
Jean's gonna kick off the end rail on our right. She'll hit the one here. She did. Now Eva's got a shot. Eva's got a long straight in on the one in the right-hand corner, the upper right corner.
That's a nice shot right there. You'll see it come right into your living room.
Again, Eva beats Jean to the shot. She's out playing her, Steve. Down table. She gives a little body English, gets it back up. Now she can make the 3 in the side with no problem. The difficult part of this shot is how does she get back down table for the 4? The 4 being to her left. She's going to have to really hit this ball hard, harder than she would have liked. She did, and scratched.
So, Mattia, what the scratch gives Baluk his ball in hand, and let's see if Jean can take advantage of the mistake. You know, if you're a follower of billiards, you're just waiting for Balukas to explode and get herself back into the game, into the match.
Well, this is the first good opportunity she's had this set. She needs to run this rack to get her confidence back. She's a little shook up right now. I think she's beginning to wonder herself if she can win this match. I don't think she got there. She didn't roll far enough. She left herself behind the 7 ball.
Just looking for that cue ball to roll a little farther, or she would have had a straight shot at the 4 ball in the side pocket, in the corner pocket.
She's kicking off the end rail. Eva's got a shot at the 4. She'll attempt to cut this ball in the upper right-hand corner. Nicely done. She went farther than she wanted. She wanted to cut the 5 ball in the lower right-hand corner. She's going to study this a moment. Yeah, she's looking at that corner, but it's a backwards cut shot. Our lower right-hand corner pocket. This is a tough shot here. But Eve's been making these tough shots tonight. Tried to play a billiard, the 5 off the 9. Didn't work. She left Gina shot, but a difficult one at the 5 ball. the 6-9 are lined up for a combination. Yeah, if she can make this 5, she should be able to make the 6-9 combo. She missed.
And you can see Belukas there, you see Jean just sitting back down as she's trying to
just
get herself back. She's probably thinking to herself, what's going on over here?
Mm-hmm. I've seen this happen to other pool players where they get weak. They lose their composure, but it's very rare that it happens to Jean Belukas. I wouldn't count her out, but it's beginning to look like Eva Mataya is in charge of this match. She's playing a little safety here. She wants to put the cue ball behind 6. Oh, she made a beautiful safety. Beautiful safety.
Cue ball resting directly behind the 6 ball, and she played a safety and played it to perfection.
Yep, Jean's going to have to
get a good look at it.
Yep, that's her problem. The 6. She's going to jump over the 6. She's using the short jump cue. She's going to try a jump shot here. She did it. What a shot. What a shot.
The jump shot nets her 2 points, so to speak. Let's take a look at that again, Jay.
She's going to go right over the 6, made the 5 in the corner, but look what happened. She came all the way around for the 6 and left herself behind the 9. She's kidding around. She's going to jump over the 9.
We were playing basketball. That's nothing but net, that jump shot.
She's going to have to kick at this 6 ball. Uh-oh. You know what's going to happen next. Eva's got ball in hand. She's going to put it right behind that 6 and try to play that 6-9 combination. So the great jump shot was to no avail for Jean Belukas. Eva should make this. That's it. You're looking right at it. Right in.
So Mataya now.
She can do no wrong.
Mataya cannot do any wrong as Mataya now in the second set leads it 2-0. Let's take a look at that winning shot.
Straight in combination.
You know, at that point, when Belukas hit that, quote, jump shot, so to speak, you would say, hey, that may be the break that Jean's looking for to get her back in the game. And then she comes back and with a foul, and it typifies the evening that Jean's been going through.
Can't seem to get anything going. You're right, Steve. If she'd had a shot at the 6 ball and been able to run that rack, she might have been right back in the match. Well, these balls are all tied up here. I think what we're going to see here, Jean is going to play a safety. Maybe not. She might be planning to play a combination, the 1-2. No, she did. She played the safe. Just lagged the 1 down off the end rail, left the cue ball tied up behind the 2. Now Eva's got to do some kicking, and I'll tell you, this is a tough ball to hit here.
Do you see the configuration on the table?
I don't know how she's going to get to this 1 ball. She's going to try and go 2 rails out of the corner. Hit the 1. Good hit. Excellent hit. Excellent. Well, she left Jean a shot, but she didn't give her ball in hand. She made the 2, but she slid over behind the 5. Jean can't get anything going. She's going to have to kick at this 3 ball. She does. She kicks. The 7's coming. The 7's coming. Fell in. She got a lucky roll there. Maybe that's the break she needs. Shoot the 4 in the end. Right there. 5 ball on the other end. Lower left corner. Come back across the table for the 6. Boy, it's a long time since we've seen Gene shoot any balls in. Got a good angle on the 8. Gene's going to win a game here.
Let's see if that particular game pushes Belukis over the hump and gets her back into the set. She's down 2-1 in games, the second and final set for the championship. And there you see Eva Mataya finds herself now with a 1-game lead, and it seemed like Belukis was starting to get her stroke back toward the end of that particular run, Jay.
Well, she's been in a slump now for about 10 games, but I've been watching her play for 15 years, and she's a great player. I say she's still the favorite in the match. She's certainly not out of this set. A 1-game lead is not much of an advantage.
Good look at the Brooklyn native, 27 years old, a 6-time U.S. champion.
She's won over 30 major titles in a 17-year career. I think she'll be good for about another 17. If anything, her game is better now than ever. She plays a safety. She leaves the cue ball frozen to the rail, the most difficult place to shoot from. Eva's got to shoot this 1 ball all the way down in the left-hand corner. Very tough shot, very tough shot. Strategy worked. Gene's got this 1 ball on the side. The way these balls are spread, I think Gene's going to get this rack too. Shoot the 2 in the corner, the right-hand corner. Come across table for the 3. She's got a little problem here with the 5 ball. Not sure where she's going to shoot that. I think she wants to slide over and shoot the 5 in the other end pocket. No, she drew back. Nice draw stroke. Shoot the 5 in the lower right corner. The 6 goes in the side. She should have this rack.
Just keeping that cue ball out in the middle of the green, and that's given her the opportunity for some easy shots.
Down table with a cue ball. Seven in the corner. Nice easy little shot on the 9 ball, right to us.
Gene finishes off that rack real well.
That looked like the Gene Belukis of old. And Belukis now ties it at 2. We're going to take a look at that last shot again that has tied this second and final setup at 2. Take a look at it.
Little cut on the 9 ball into the corner pocket. That's where you want to be in the 9. You want to have your cue ball real close to it. made a ball on the break. She's got the one on the side. The balls are spread out nicely, except the 5, 7, 8 is in a little tight cluster. You see it by the side pocket. She's going to have to maneuver around those balls a little bit to run this rack. She's looking to see if the 5 will pass the 7 and go in the side pocket. I think what she probably will try to do is break them up. I don't know if she can do it off the one ball or not. I doubt it. No. Shoot the 3 in the upper right corner. Now our lower left corner. Comes back up for the 4. The 4 goes in that lower left-hand corner. I think the 5 must go by the 7 ball into the side pocket. Yep, that's the way she's playing it. She's got a half a pocket here. She doesn't have a full pocket. Maybe less than a half a pocket, but she can make it. Yeah. She makes it.
Just got by
the 8 over a little bit, out of the way. She's got this rack too. She's starting to play again. Comes around for the 7 ball. Trying to decide if she wants to follow the cue ball off the 7 or draw it back. Looks like she's drawing. She drew back for the 8. No problem. Jean's back in control.
Nice position with the cue ball. She'll run this one out and grab her 3rd game and lead the set 3-2. And there you get a good look at Eva Mattia, who has been on the chair for quite some time as Belukis has gotten that confidence back and hitting the balls very well. Let's take a look at the last couple of shots.
Here's the final 9 ball that game. Nice straight in shot. Referee Robert Haddad finishes racking the balls. Things are beginning to look familiar again. Jean Belukis shooting pool, her opponent sitting in the chair.
The last 2 breaks, Jean had knocked in at least 1 ball. In this 3rd break, she comes up empty and even now. We'll see what she could do.
Well, she doesn't have a good shot at the 1. I think she's going to try and play a safety here. Well, she didn't do what she wanted. She left Jean an opening to play a good safety. I think Jean will probably shoot the 1 ball behind those balls to the lower right, the 5 and 6, forcing Eva to kick at the 1. Well, she did it the other way. She put the cue ball behind the 9.
Doesn't appear there's much Mattia could do with this shot.
Well, she's got a kick at the 1, and she doesn't really have an opening to get to it. She's going to try and jump the ball, too. Eva takes that short jump cue out. That's that specially made Hubler jump cue. It's about 48 inches long. She's going to jump over the 9 and hit the 1. Nope, she hit the 9. Jean will get ball in hand.
Well, nice effort by Mattia as he tried to jump over the 9 and kicking the one on the corner pocket. It didn't materialize, and now ball in hand to Belukas. And here's a look at that last shot.
She wanted to get over that nine ball. She nicked it on the top going over.
Belukas with a 3-2 lead in the second and final set for the championship of this Classic Cup 6-9 ball tournament. Mattia captured the first set 9-4, which has forced this second set.
The winner of this match will get $3,200 and be the Classic Cup champion. The loser gets a consolation prize of $2,300. Three in the side, slide over for the four ball. Four in the side, good shot. She barely missed the nine going down there. If she'd hit that nine, she'd have been in trouble. She's okay, she'll shoot the five in the right-hand corner. Back across table, perfect position on the six. Jean's back in control, Steve.
Well, she's had a good run the last couple of trips down, and in this particular game, she's certainly looks like she's about to close it out.
Perfect position, eight in the side, the cue ball, fall down table, be right on the nine, here it comes. Straight into the nine. That's the shot you want at the nine ball right there.
Belukas in total control that time as she was in command of that cue ball, positioning it well, keeping it in the middle of the table. And with her efforts now, she moves out in front 4-2 in his second and final set. Boy, she had total control of that cue ball that time, just keeping it in the middle and setting herself up for good shots.
The all-important break shot. There goes the nine ball. It's not going in, but it went down by the corner pocket. She left herself a long shot on the one. I'm not certain that it will go past the seven. We should look at that angle again, looking straight down at the one and the cue ball. We can see if the one will pass the seven ball. Yep, that's it. Not sure if it goes. No, it doesn't. She's playing a safety. Oh! She's scratching the side.
So ball in hand now to Mattia.
Well, Eva's got to get something going here right now. You don't want to get behind Jean Belukas. Jean knows how to win. Once she gets in the lead, she starts piling those games on. Two in the end. Right at us. Little soft draw shot there. Just let that cue ball slide over. This is the critical shot here to get position on the five. It's gonna shoot that four in the end and bring the cue ball back up table. Very nice shot, very nice shot. She's got a difficult angle at the five. Gonna make the five in the upper left-hand corner.
Beautiful shot. She had to contend with that six ball. And,
yeah, now she's got to make the six in the same corner, but this nine partially blocks the pocket. As you can see, this is a very tight shot to get the six past the nine here. Nice shot. Nice shot. Cue ball's coming down the table a little further than she'd like. Yeah. She wanted to have a little better angle on the seven. She's got a tough shot here. She's going to shoot that seven in the upper right-hand corner. Problem with this shot is she's got to turn the cue ball loose. Nope, she missed it. Didn't give up much, though. Jean's faced with a dilemma here. Looks like she's going to have to bank the seven.
Here's that last shot.
Yes, she undercut it.
Undercut a little bit.
We're going to see a bank shot here. I think Jean's going to shoot at this ball. She's going to try and bank it all the way back up in the other end. She did. Missed it. It's going to set up perfectly for Eva to shoot the seven on the side, stop the cue ball. Well, Eva got a break there. She missed and didn't give up much. Soft little stop shot. The cue ball slides over. She'll shoot the eight in the end, bring the cue ball back a few inches. Just like that. The nine in the other corner. Keeps the pressure on.
So Mattia captures her third game in this second and final set.
The score now, Baluk is 4 and Mattia 3. And Mattia now with a chance to break and get herself back in this set.
Got a good match here. Need a good break shot. Nothing on the break. She's got a shot at the one ball. Jean's got a shot at the one. The four is tied up on the side rail by the six. That's what she's looking at now. The players survey the rack to see what they're going to have to do to run out. That's what she's checking when she got down with a cue stick just now. She can make the one, two, three, but it's what to do with the four that the problem is. Makes the one. She'd like to get in position on the three ball to break up the 6-4. Shoot the three in the side. Come around the table, three rails. I think the four will go in the end, I'm not sure. Kind of, she's shooting at it. She's shooting the four down in the end. Nope, she played a safety, a good safety. Yes.
There's that cue ball resting directly behind the six ball. And that was a very good safety by Lucas.
Forcing Eva to kick at the four ball.
Like those two balls were out on an island. Just sitting out there all by themselves. Mm-hmm. And there you see.
That's Eva's predicament.
Yep.
She's going to try and go two rails out of the corner to hit the four. Nope. She came short. Jean Baluchas has ball in hand. The balls are all spread out. She's checking to see where she wants to be for the six ball. That's the critical shot remaining on this rack. She'll make the four and the five okay. The only difficulty she has in finishing this rack off is to get position for that six ball that's on the side rail. You see it up there by the seven. Making the ball is only half the battle in nine ball. The position of the cue ball is the other half. Without good position, you don't have a chance. She brings the cue ball over to the side rail. Not a bad shot. She's got to run that six all the way down the side rail into the end. She made it. That takes care of that predicament.
But Lucas now with a clear shot to run out the table. And the cue ball comes back in a favorable position for her.
She'll eight knock in this, the end.
Yep, eight ball in the corner. And the cue ball just bounces right back, and she'll finish out the nine ball in the other corner.
That does it. Nice run out there.
Once again, Belucas in control of that cue ball in that particular game. And now she moves back in front, 5-3.
I think she's going to be hard for Eva to catch now. Scratch on the break.
Scratch on the break. Nice solid hit that time by Jean. And she knocked the ball in, but she also knocked the cue ball in. And referee to Mateo.
Right. Bob Haddad, the referee, spots up the three and the six ball.
Mateo now sizing up her shots. She'll have it behind the head string. And you see the shot combination that Mateo
she's
going to
have to break.
At.
Yeah, she's going to have to break up that three and six. I think she's going to try and do it right now. If she wants to run this rack, she's going to have to move those balls. No, she's going to do it off the two. She'll shoot the two in the lower right-hand corner. Draw the cue ball up into the 3-6-9. Just like that. Didn't quite get there. I don't believe she can make the three in the side. She can hit the three, but whether she can make it or not, I don't think so. Nope. Perhaps. Looks like a safety here. Yes, it is. She put the three over on the side rail where Jean's faced with a difficult combination, the 3-4 combination. Left Eva a relatively easy 3-7 combination. Eva's got to be careful she doesn't get the cue ball tied up. She did a good job. She knocked the nine out of the way. This should be her rack. Shoot the three in the corner. Just a soft little roll to keep her angle on the four.
As long as she controls that cue ball, as you said, really not a difficult shot on the table.
She'll follow the cue ball, I believe. Let's see. Looks like she's drawing it here. Yeah, she is. Almost got in trouble with that six ball. She's going to shoot the five in the side right by the eight. Reason she did it this way is she can shoot the five into the eight and use it as a sideboard. Which she did.
Now she's in a perfect position for that six ball in the corner.
Right. Her decision here is does she want to come back and shoot the eight in the end, or does she want to bring the cue ball up the table and shoot the eight in the side? That's what she's circling and figuring out. Looks like she's going to... Yep. Beautiful.
She had a couple of options that time, didn't she?
Yes. She drew the cue ball into perfect position for the eight. Now she'll have the nine in the corner pocket. Left-hand corner, nine ball. Very good.
Makaya runs it, and she now cuts into the lead 5-4.
This match is not over. He was battling back.
Let's take a look at the last couple of shots by Makaya. There you see.
This is the critical shot. She draws this cue ball back up the table in position for the eight. Here comes the break shot. Here we go.
Back to live action.
Nice break. Look out, five ball. Look out, five ball. She made the two on the break. She's got a shot at the one here. Right in that corner in front of us. That was a tough shot, and she missed it.
She had to contend with the seven ball at that side, and came up a little short.
She left Jean in a good position to run this rack. She's got a long shot down the rail on the one ball. She's going to shoot that one in the far right-hand corner pocket. There we go. Lower right-hand corner. Right in. She's right on the three ball. The positioning for the four is critical, this rack. That four, yes.
I think she may draw it back.
Very nicely done. Very nicely done. She got back above the four. That's what she wanted to do. She'll shoot the four in the right-hand corner again. This is no bargain here. She's going to have to shoot that five up in the left-hand corner. Makes it. Nice shot.
Little body English that time from Belukas as she got that five ball to fall in the corner pocket. Looks like she's in pretty good shape here, Jay.
Yeah. She got the tough shots out of the way. Six in the corner. I'm kind of surprised she went that way. She left herself in a bad spot here. She's straight in on the rail. I'm not sure why she didn't draw the cue ball there.
What makes that shot so difficult, having the cue ball riding the rail?
It's hard for her to cue the ball properly to move the cue ball around. And she's straight in, which makes it even more difficult. Yep, she missed it. She got a lucky roll there.
Kind of body English on that one.
But it's kind of out of the frying pan into the fire because she's got a real difficult shot on the eight ball. She's going to have to try and run that eight ball down the rail into the left-hand corner pocket, the lower left corner pocket. Nice shot. She's struggling on this rack. This is a tough shot on the nine, too. She's cutting that ball in the lower right-hand corner pocket. Missed it. No, she made it. She made it.
So Belukas had some difficult shots toward the end, and she answered.
Okay, we are back at the Pheasant Run Resort Hotel. Nine ball, Classic Cup 6, women's final. Belukas in this second set leads it 6-4. And the first one that gets to nine will be the champion. But
she's not happy with the rack. She's asked referee Robert Haddad to rack him again. The players want a good, tight rack. If any balls are loose, the balls don't spread apart.
Mattia won the first set 9-4, and it has forced this second and final set.
Scratch on the break.
He was going to have ball in hand behind the head string, and a pretty nice setup here. She really needs this rack, Steve, to get in this match. Remember, she's playing the best woman player of all time. You just can't spot her a three-game lead. And she knows it. She knows this is do or die, this rack. Watch out, eight ball. Watch out, eight ball. It got her. Hook behind the eight. If we look a little bit to the left, we'll see where the three ball is. We still don't see it, but she's behind the eight. Now we see. She's going to have to kick here. She's going to try and kick and play safe. That's it. That's what she wanted to do, but she didn't do it.
I like that shot when we're zoomed right in and then we pull out a little bit. It kind of gives us a nice perspective of the table.
Right. That was well done by the cameraman. Jean shoots the three, rolls right back. She wants to shoot the four in the same corner pocket. She'll let that cue ball just fall a few inches and then shoot the five in the side. Looking more and more like Jean's going to extend that string to 10 straight tournaments. Although she's gotten a scare here tonight. Ava Mattia showed she can win. She's going to have to shoot this six in the end and draw the cue ball all the way back up the table. Going to draw all the way back up where she's at to shoot the seven next, like that. Went a little bit further than she wanted.
Got that seven ball now lying right behind the nine ball.
There
we see it right there.
She wants to make it in that upper left-hand corner pocket. It can be done. This is a tough shot. This is a thin hit. She did it. Beautiful shot.
Couldn't get any tighter than that.
Nope. If she'd have gone another inch, she'd have never been able to make that shot.
We're going to take a look at that shot once we get a chance, as that could be the game winner right there.
Nine ball straight in. That's it. If we see this shot again, you'll see that she just had room to see the seven ball.
So now Balukas with the lead, 7-4. Let's take a look at that critical shot. Beautiful.
She hit it very nicely.
Just cut it just enough, and a seven ball dropped. And Balukas now, with that critical shot, ran the rest of the balls on the table, and she now leads it 7-4.
She moved over on the break shot a little bit here. One's going to the side. She's got a shot at the two. She's got to shoot that two all the way down in the right-hand corner. That's the two. If we draw back a little bit, you'll see where she's got to go with it in the upper right-hand corner here. She's looking at the shot. Now it's our lower left corner. That's where the two's going, right towards us. Good camera angle. She makes a nice shot. I think she better take a look at this. This is, she'll shoot the three in the left-hand corner, the lower left, just like that. Come around the table for the four. Nice job. She's playing well again. And she's back on her game. Jean's hitting the balls like this, I don't think there's a woman out there that can challenge her. Not too many men either.
She's certainly in a groove right now as everything is just falling into place for Jean.
She hit the eight. She's all right. She almost got tied up. These are all fairly tough shots. Anytime you've got long green, it's not easy. She's hitting right in the center of the pocket, though. The players have had trouble all week with difficult draw shots where they've got to put an excessive amount of draw on the ball. There's been a lot of miscueing. I don't know if it's a bad batch of chalk or what. She's got to draw this ball pretty severely, just like this. Almost drew it in the side pocket. She almost overdrew the ball. She's got the same kind of shot that Eva missed a couple games ago on the seven ball. She's got to cut it in the upper right-hand corner. Nice job.
So Jean DeLucas continues her run as she moves out in front 8-4 in this second set. And apparently, she's in control.
She's on the hill.
Take a look at that.
She drew it so much, she almost drew it in the side pocket.
That was the eight ball. Then she comes up, and as you said, Eva had a shot similar to this a couple of games ago, and Belukas this time, where Eva failed to knock it in, gently puts it in.
Nice, thin cut shot. Nothing on the break. Eva's got a little combination or perhaps a billiard here. I'm not sure what she's going to do with this. She may shoot the one into the six or she may shoot. She's playing the billiard. She's going to shoot off the one, make the six with the cue ball. Softly, just like that. Lays herself a nice straight in shot at the one down the end rail. Excuse me, the side rail. Not sure where she's going to go with the two ball next. She may be playing a safety with this two ball. No, she played a combination. It's a good shot. She hit that real well. Excellent shot. Three in the corner. She left herself positioned for the 4-9 combination. She's got perfect position on it, but these are not easy shots, Steve. They can be missed.
Looks like it's pretty straight on, but she's going to have to cut it a little bit, it appears.
She's lining it up right now, the four into the nine. She wants to make the nine in the lower right-hand corner pocket. She needs this. Good shot.
She got it.
Hit it perfect.
The combination, the 4-9 combination, has kept Eva Mataya alive in this set. Take a look at it once again, Jay.
Nice combination here. Got to hit these shots perfect. And she did.
no margin for error right there, and Mattia remains alive as she now trails Belukas 8-5 in the second and final set.
Jean may win this match, but she's not going to forget it. She's been severely tested here tonight. Ooh. Scratch on the break. Jean's got ball in hand behind the line again. She'd like to run this rack and get this match over with. The balls are sitting good. No real problems here. She can make that one ball, bring her cue ball back a little bit for the two ball. We might see a champion. She didn't try to draw for position. She just slid the cue ball over a few inches. That's it. Draw back wings. There's the two ball. It's going to have to go in the lower left corner, just like that. She knows this rack could spell victory. She's going to be real careful here. Jean's going for her 10th title in a row. This is Queen Jean, they call her. The greatest. The queen was severely tested tonight, but she was up to it, Steve.
She struggled early, no question about it. That first set clearly dominated by Mattia, and then Jean struggled early in the second set here in the second set, but she shook off the cobweb, so to speak, and now she's been on a roll ever since.
She's running out the string here. She'll shoot the seven in the side. Just slide that cue ball down the table. Off the end rail. The eight ball go in the side also.
And you can feel the crowd senses a victory.
Yep. She'll just follow the cue ball a little bit down the table. No, she drew it over. She wants to shoot the nine in the end. She's in good position. She should have this one. That upper left corner pocket. And that's victory, Jean Belukas.
Jean Belukas with her 10th consecutive tournament victory in a row. She captures the 1987 Classic Cup 6 tournament. And there you get a good look at the champion right there. And she struggled early, but as champions do, they shake loose.
There's the final nine ball.
There's the winning shot.
We'll be down and talking with Jean and Eva in just a minute.
We'll be right back. Back at the Pheasant Run Resort Hotel, and the 1987 Classic Cup 6 Women's Championship was captured by Jean Belukas. And Jay, I have to tell you, Jean struggled a little bit early on, and Eva came out firing, but in the end, the six-time champion pulled out the victory.
It was a great match. It was a real exciting match. It was really in doubt all the way till the end of the second set. Eva never gave up. I'm real thrilled about the way both girls played.
And while we're speaking of both girls, we have them with us right now. And Jay, why don't you do the honors?
Great. Thank you, Steve. Jean, congratulations. It was a great tournament.
Thank you, Jay.
Okay. Eva, congratulations to you, too. You played a great match. I think that's the first set Jean's lost in about 6 months.
Yeah, since last time we played in Charlotte, as a matter of fact.
Great, great. Thank you very much. Jean, is there anything you'd like to say to the people? Anything, any acknowledgement you'd like to make?
Well, I'd like to thank Harold and Shari Simonson for running such a beautiful tournament. The Pheasant Run has been a great hotel to have a tournament of this caliber here. And also Mr. Willard and the people who set up the pool tables. Everything was just excellent. And
that was,
Eva by far is my toughest opponent. She really pumps up against me and she plays well. And I'm sure that we'll have many exciting matches in the future.
Great. Thanks a lot, Jean. At this time, we're going to have somebody present the awards, Mr. Frank Vandebosch. He'll present to the winner, but right now we're going to have Shari Simonson from the co-sponsor Pool and Billiard Magazine. She's going to present the runner-up awards. Shari?
Thank you, Jay. Lori John, I'd like to present you with the third-place plaque.
Thank you.
Congratulations to you.
No, just that they played a great finals, and
that it?
Okay. Have a second. Eva, you played a great final. Very
Thank
proud
you.
Of you. Congratulations to you.
Great.
Want to say something?
Thanks very much, Sherry. Now to present the Winner's Award, Mr. Frank Vannebosch from Jobup Trading Company. Frank?
Thank you very much. Jane, you did a real nice, that was a beautiful tournament, great performance.
Thank you, Frank. Thank you very much.
Thank you for playing so well and making it a success.
Thank you.
Thanks very much, Frank. And now the other tournament co-sponsor, Jim Willard, with a check for the winner. Jim?
The important stuff here, right?
Yep, this is the big money. Gene, it's been a pleasure, and here's a check for $3,200.
Thank you very much, Mr. Willard.
Thank you for coming.
Thanks
a lot, Jim.